today. From SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California. It's week 15 of the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Jared Goff and the Los Angeles Rams taking on Sam Darnold and the New York Jets.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Today, we reach week 15, and we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Jets and the Los Angeles Rams. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Rams team as they interplay. And they lost three straight here, and it goes without saying, I guess, they could certainly use a win.
And how do they get a win? Because they've lost three straight, I think it's paramount that they get a fast, clean start to this game.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Jets, they come into this one knowing it's been a while since tasting victory. They've dropped four in a row.
Can they remember what it was like to win a game? In these types of situations, you're looking for someone to inspire you, and it doesn't have to be one of your best players either.
Goff on first down. And that's caught left side. It's Woods. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
To throw again on second down, Goff. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
An early test. Two plays in. This is third and two. Here's the first carry of the game for Cam Akers. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A shotgun snap for Goff. Quick hitter here, it's complete.
Goff's pass.
And he's already got two catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. First down, they go back to Burkhead. Gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Goff's throw here finds Woods. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're on the sidelines thinking themselves and expressing. Let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here. Defensively, they better figure something out. Opening drive, he already has 4 catches.
And if you have to figure out how to stop him defensively, that usually means you weaken your defense. That means that now the offense is doing the dictating, and they should have other things open up as well.
Yards.
And that put him over 1,000 yards for the season. And the benchmark for running backs, 1,000 yards. The same for receivers. When you have that kind of a year, you've had a monster one.
So first and goal now from the 7-yard line. That's lost 3 straight games. Scoring first in this first quarter has to feel pretty good.
That's feel great for them, and also it's a nice signal to the rest of the team, because we talk about complimentary football all the time. So they've now signaled to the defense, now signaled to the kicking game, hey, we're here to play in this one. We're going to do our part. Let's see if you guys will do the exact same, and we can break this losing streak.
Now Adam Vinatieri for the point after. It's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays, and it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Returnable here for Davis. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Jets offense ready for their first possession, and they are led by the 23-year-old from USC in his third year now, quarterback Sam Darnold.
Now, the meeting we had with him this week, that's one of the briefer ones we've ever had, isn't it?
He wasn't too happy after last week.
Not happy. Really determined to play a whole lot better, and he really can't play a whole lot worse. He's got to go out and show the team that the goods that he exhibited early are still there. Otherwise, he could lose the confidence that they have in him.
Yeah, hoping to get rid of that interception bug. On first down, it's Darnold. He's going to find his tight end. That's Chris Herndon. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit, after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, He looked like one of those guys.
Well, he is marked down right about on top of that imaginary yellow line, but they say he's a bit short. An ideal start defensively. They already have the touchdown. Now they get the stop.
Just like they drew it up on the chalkboard. Does that sound dated? Right? Am I out of touch a little bit?
It's all right.
All right, grease board, heck, computer, exactly what you want, though. Score on your first drive, stop them on the first drive defensively.
They'll go for it with Bell. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there. But they do convert on fourth.
2 yards.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. And that is intercepted by the Pro Bowler, Jalen Ramsey. And they take over the setup shot at the 46-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, right? Because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right, it felt like a matter of time, and you got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
First down.
Give him 8 on the play, and it'll be a second down.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Rams 7, Jets nothing.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Now a toss running left, Akers. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
On first down, it's gone. Got a man open. It's Tyler Higbee. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
That's good.
Call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
1st and 10.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
This will be caught just inside the 10. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
It's a gain of 9.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
First down marker at the 5. It's 2nd and goal. On the handoff, it's Akers. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there, but of course you're going to give it to him.
Goff wants to throw on 3rd and 1. The Jets defense making things difficult there. 4th down.
They went with the dive look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs. Blanketed everyone. Took away all the passing angles. Thus, the incompletion.
Andy Reid, some say always unpredictable. And here he says, we're going for it on 4th down. Now the short yardage man, Burkhead. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. They opt to go for it, and they get it. 1st and goal after a pickup of 5. They'll try and pound it in with Burkhead. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Rex Burkhead, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Rams tack on to their advantage. 2nd effort there. He was determined to find pay dirt, and he did.
I think that's a great example of what coaches talk about, a back that runs behind his pads, and he uses pads to get him into the end zone.
Vinatieri now for the point after. And it's good to make it 14-0. So that winds up a seven-play drive all told. And it ends with a one-yard touchdown run.
Nothing.
This about 5 yards deep. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Jets take over first and 10. At their own.
Back onto the field come the New York Jets for their second drive. The partner just looking at some of the struggles they've had this season. The playoffs are not in their future. As they start to peer toward the offseason, what moves might they make?
I think the running back position. And I know we talk all the time about the NFL being a passing league. But the teams that run the ball effectively, they're the ones that go deep into the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl. They have to upgrade here. And you and I both know in recent years in the draft, people have shied away.
Oh, the ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by number 27. And he will take this down to the 10-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
L.A. set to take over again on offense. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, they could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But it's the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? Mm. So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Cooper Kupp, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Rams add on to their lead.
Partner, remember that old film of Peyton Manning going through the route tree with his great receivers in Indianapolis? I think we're seeing the results of the same type of work here today. These guys know each other so well, they don't even have to call the play. They can just look each other and know the route that's going to be run, and usually the connection is perfect.
And it is now 21-0. Well, they got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone.
Nothing.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
So we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC as the Jets come back out on offense. And it's right about this time of the year that you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go, but still plenty to be determined.
It certainly is, because we all know everyone is aiming for that number one seed. But failing that, because only two teams in the NFL get a bye, one from each conference, that question becomes, who's hot? Who's peaking at the right time as you start the playoffs?
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. A give to Bell. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Bell, the Jets.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
And a good job defensively. They stopped him short of the first at the 32.
Come on, baby. We got to do our job.
So they decline it, as that will bring up fourth.
And I know that yardage and field position are keys to any game played, but you've got to consider downs when you're talking about penalties. And they wisely did not take that one and made it fourth down.
Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They'll run it with Bell. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. A solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Micah Kizer was in on the tackle. 38-yard line, second and nine.
Second and nine at the 38-yard line.
And they'll try the air now with Darnold. And Darnold got to be intercepted for the third time. He's picked off at his own 37. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December, right? It is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. After the interception, here's Goff. Right side complete, that's Woods. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches at the 28-yard line.
Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. A good position to be in here, second and inches. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Now this one was tied in out on the right side. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down.
And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown Rams. Jared Goff with his... onto their lead. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution. They've retained their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Vinatieri now to tack on the PAT. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, pay dirt. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. Le'Veon Bell and the Jets ready to begin their next drive. A 1,000-yard campaign in his sights, Charles, but needs a little bit of a kick here down the stretch to reach it.
And sometimes at this stage of the season, you're looking for that extra goal, right? That extra motivation to accomplish what you want, not just as a team, but as individuals. He's got to stretch a little bit to get there. That might be what they're talking about during the practice sessions in their meetings. Hey, we can still get this done. Let's go ahead and feed him the ball.
And the offensive line, I'm sure they're well aware of where he stands as well.
They are, and I think for them, it would be an even better accomplishment to get there now because it seems like a little bit of a reach.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game. And it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. tackled right on the chalk of the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Carry there by Le'Veon Bell. And he's just trying to get back to the form he exhibited in Pittsburgh when he was one of the top backs in the NFL. In 2019, though, no games over 100 yards rushing and only three games with 20 or more carries. The more he touches it, the more effective he is.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. No
gain on the play. I would think as a play call, you want to look for some quick hitters to your tight end. Any type of a route to replace where that linebacker was. Because when you saw the speed with which he reacted and stumped that play, maybe use that speed against him in the future.
Time after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, time for a sprint to the finish as it's time to get you caught up with what's happening around the NFL here in a pivotal Week 15. Lastly, let's check on one final game for you. And you can see they are scoreless as they play the second quarter. In the game you're watching, it was Jared Goff with a strong first half. His three touchdown passes have his guys out in front as we hand things back over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started.
Ashton Davis on the return. The Jets take over first and 10.
Sam Darnold leading the offense out for their next possession. And that first half was nothing short of a disaster. 0 points on the scoreboard and a big three in the INT column.
So they've got to get him going, obviously, right? So you've got to get him in rhythm. And we always think of short passes. I think of jet sweeps where they just kind of toss the ball forward. You know, that counts as a forward pass.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off near the 26. And his guys are going to get the football. 23-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers.
Number 23.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. From the gun, here's Goff. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a physical and force that incompletion.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Out of the gun, Goff. And that is incomplete.
Goff's pass.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
On now is Vinatieri as he'll try the field goal. And this a 39-yard attempt. Vinatieri's kick is good. And they're well on their way now as the lead grows even larger.
Rams 31, Jets nothing.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
The offense trots back onto the field, and we shot our Madden spotlight on Sam Darnold. And unfortunately for him, this montage, not highlights, lowlights in this one, partner.
Way too many mistakes, too many errors. Sometimes it's on the guy throwing the ball, sometimes it's on the teammates, but it all comes back to him. It goes on his ledger. So when you're playing this type of a game, you start to look for other ways to get out of it. Do you throw it to shorter passes, some checkdowns, maybe use your legs a little bit more, don't throw the ball downfield. All those things you're looking for, and then you got to watch the tape and figure it all out so the next time it doesn't happen again.
So far the tape, four interceptions. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and nine. The give is to Bell. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
Le'Veon Bell, the Jets.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Bit of a surprise. They ran it on third and medium. Proved to be the right call. First and 10.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on third and 5, third and 6, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
Now, after the run by Bell, here's another first and 10. Give it here to his running back. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. This is Bell. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. A good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Nothing in that first half, nothing on the last drive, but they're moving now with a first and 10. Bell. And he'll be brought down at about the 42.
Le'Veon Bell.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Throwing on second and 8. Darnold, he's got Herndon, his tight end. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 25-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Now Bell. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Bell, the ball carrier.
Michael Brockers in on the stop. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
At the 25-yard line.
Now Darnold. And it's knocked away and incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there. And it's third down.
What we've seen so far in this game, they're not going to allow a big shot over the top. You can have whatever you want underneath. They'll give you that, but they're not going to let you beat them deep.
Drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. Here's Bell. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13.
Jalen Ramsey brought him down.
And Charles, you look at this offense, their struggles moving the ball well documented. Dead last in the NFL in first downs, but signs of life there.
Yeah, and you and I do, I think, a really good job of respecting the game and respecting the teams. But this squad, they're in position now where their fan base gets excited when they pick up a first down. They cheer almost like they picked up a touchdown.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. To throw is Darnold. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and they come up with something here on third down. Bring up a fourth down.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Going absolutely nowhere. He'll wind up losing a yard or two. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. So they finally get their first trip to the red zone, and it ends with nothing.
And that's what I'm going to focus on with you, because you teed it up really well. Finally get to the red zone. So it's got to be a little bit of frustration because they haven't moved the ball as well as they wanted to all game. Now they get there, but we got to go for it because we don't know if we can get back here again. We don't know how many opportunities because they've been sputtering a little bit.
Absolutely. At this stage in the second half, to get there and not get it for the first time, tough. Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Second and 8. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he is going to lose yardage here. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
The Rams on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Here's Goff. And able to find Higbee, it's complete. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. First down, Los Angeles there with a pickup of 14 yards.
Partner, I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
Ready. A give to Burkhead on first down. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
8 yards.
Here's a second and two now from the 33.
At the 33-yard line.
Oh, fighting off the defender. They can't corral him.
That was well coached and even better executed, because you saw him looking for the cutback lane, never materialized, and had excellent pursuit to stack that play up.
The Rams on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35. They needed a yard. They got it. First down.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Out of the shotgun, a give to Burkhead. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Damon Harrison, the one on the stop.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. Now Goff. And got him in. It's Rollins. And it's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 37. A really nice gain of 25 yards. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
So in Jet territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 37-yard line. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Brings up 2nd and 11 at the Jets' 38-yard line.
Second and 11. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. Now the 6-year man from Texas, this is Malcolm Brown. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with 3rd and about 6 yards to go.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
Throwing on 3rd, gone. And a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked by Pierre Desir. This game still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Taylor Redd for the pick. And a short return to the 6-yard line.
I know we could sit up here and dance around it a little bit, but going for two in this situation, somebody doesn't like someone else. There's no doubt in my mind.
Well, what they couldn't see is you lean back in your chair and you went, I mean, that's not a good decision. They didn't get it, though.
Yeah, I don't think you just say, well, my kicker's hurt in this spot.
No.
No.
I'm going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Automatic first down.
So good field position for the Rams as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Rams trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
Vinatieri now for the point after. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Well, I'm not sure if they drew that play up to score, but it scored indeed. One play on the ground and into the end zone for 6. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Returnable here for Davis. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Rams take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
New York ready to go again offensively. It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just has not been the case. They'll come out with a 3 tight end look on the first play of the drive. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now. But that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
They show run with 3 tight ends here on first down. Again, it's Bell. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Kendall Beckwith on the stop.
But from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Second down, it's Bell, and he'll get this across the 40 and up to about the 42-yard line. So the LA Rams with a victory here, and I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done, really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball. You're handing out multiple, although I set you up by saying game balls, plural.
Yeah,
but I
like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent, like, the best player of all of that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people. I thought I was the only child.
You get a game ball, and you get